Hello, welcome to the NIH course on the Introduction to the Principles and Practice of Clinical Research. The IPPCR course trains participants on how to effectively and safely conduct clinical research. The IPPCR course was founded in 1995 by Dr. John Gallen. Dr. Gallen and a group of experts from within and outside the NIH established a curriculum focused on topics fundamental to researchers. Over the years, the course has expanded and now trains thousands of participants each year from around the world. There are currently three course directors. I'm Dr. Ann Zajcik, a pediatrician and PharmD. Dr. Lisa Cordes is a PharmD and investigator at the National Institutes of Health. And Dr. Laura Lee Johnson is a statistician at the U.S. Food and Drug Administration.
The purpose of the IPPCR course is to provide the theory and practical aspects of designing and performing safe and ethical clinical research. The course content is divided into seven modules. Module one is an introduction to clinical research, which includes an overview of product regulation and ethics in clinical research. Module two focuses on statistics and includes topics ranging from study designs to hypothesis testing. Module three, the clinical research team, is introduced, and we discuss practical considerations for protocol implementation. Module four will focus on the selection of study participants. Module five will highlight elements of writing the protocol, manuals of operating procedures and the protocol budget, and other implementation topics. The safety and monitoring aspects of research will be the focus of Module 6. Here, we'll discuss institutional review boards. Module 7 will focus on data quality and results reporting. At the end of the course, supplementary materials are provided, which includes topics of special interest. These materials are intended to be used for further learning, but the materials not included on the final exam. Dr. Cordes will now review the course portal.
Now that you are familiar with the content of the course, we would like to highlight some of the features of the course portal, which can help facilitate your learning. After logging into the course portal, the user is brought to the course homepage, which is shown here. Here, you will find a section for My Action Items. You will see the course syllabus and also see important guidelines. We also have announcements here on the right and also the course calendar. And here you can find important deadlines, such as the deadline for the final exam. Under course tools, there are some helpful resources, including the IPPCR glossary. The glossary includes a number of common abbreviations and acronyms that are used in clinical research and statistics. There are also links at the bottom of the page, such as one from clinicaltrials.gov. We can then navigate back to the course homepage here at the top, where we will find other resources at the bottom of this page, including a free protocol template. We have included links to multiple different templates, such as the NIH e-protocol writing tool, which provides two different templates. One is for phase two and three studies, and one is focused on behavioral and social science research. We can again navigate back to our homepage. And here again, at the bottom, there is a link for the budget template. This is an Excel spreadsheet that breaks down protocol cost considerations. There is also a link here to a website that contains multiple different templates for manuals of operating procedures. As we navigate back to the navigation bar at the top, we see the Modules and Lecture tab. And this is where you will find all of the lecture videos and handouts. A list of the modules for the whole course is here on the left, and you can use the search bar to search for a specific topic. So for example, if you want to search for data management, you can type that in the search bar and hit search. That will bring you all the lectures that apply to that specific topic. You can then click on that lecture, which will bring you to a lecture page. And here you can see all of the video clips here in the center, and the lecture documents on the right side. You can also view the discussion board here, or you can view the discussion board through this link at the top in the navigation bar. The discussion boards are student-driven, and so we encourage you to share your ideas and have a dialogue with fellow participants. On the left, you can also find help for potential technical issues that you might encounter. And then, after you review all the lectures for the course, you can take the final exam, and that can be found again through the course homepage. Go to Final Exam here on the left. On the final exam screen, you will see important deadlines for the final exam and also directions for taking the final exam. We are also very interested in your feedback. As we go back to the course homepage, you will see a course feedback icon here at the top navigation pane. There is also an opportunity to give feedback on the individual lectures here in the center under feedback status. We really do read each and every comment, and we do our best to improve the course each year based on participant feedback. This concludes highlights for navigating the course portal, and I will turn it back over to Dr. Zajac.
There are four learning objectives for this course. We hope you will gain an understanding of the principles involved in the ethical, legal, and regulatory issues in clinical human subjects research, including the role of the Institutional Review Board, biostatistical and epidemiologic methods involved in conducting clinical research, data collection and monitoring of patient-oriented research, and the infrastructure required to perform clinical research. We hope this course helps build your foundation in clinical research. Welcome to IPPCR.